When she was a model, she knocked people out with her looks. Now, as an Olympic boxer, she's doing it with her fists. Michaela Mayer, once the face of soft drinks and clothing lines, is now entering the ring in Rio, just hours away from the fight of her life. Here's ABC's Rachel Smith.
I think I'm a very classic boxer. Long punches, good jab, solid right hand, left hook.
Landing punches like this is what Michaela Mayer hopes will win her the fight for Olympic gold.
My ultimate goal is everything and beyond. I want to be on that podium with a gold medal, and I want to build a career off of that.
Michaela Mayer!
I first met Michaela early last year, fighting not under the bright lights of Olympic Stadium, but in this basement gym in the outskirts of Atlanta, where some of the best amateurs in the world were facing off at the Tournament of Champions, a ramp up to the Olympics. Michaela spends almost all of her time in the gym, three times a day, 6 days a week.
Bad man, the gym already.
Training her body and her mind.
My boxing workouts are literally more mentally draining than they are physically.
Now a serious Olympic medal contender, Michaela's road to Rio was an unlikely one. While her teammate Clarissa Shields started boxing as a kid and had won gold by 17. When Michaela was a teenager, she was fighting, but nowhere near a boxing ring.
Why were you kicked out of school?
I was actually kicked out of school for getting in a fight with one of my ex-best friends. That's kind of a coincidence.
She says her life was starting to take a dark turn.
When I found boxing, it just kind of, I switched gears. Mm-hmm. It focused me. I stopped going out. I stopped partying. I cracked down in school.
It seems that being in the ring is not about fighting and taking out anger. It's about discipline and technique.
Definitely. There's a bigger goal now.
To fund that goal, Michaela has had to use both her brawn and her beauty.
Millions of girls are told they're pretty.
She's been the face of Dr. Pepper.
But not many end up becoming a model.
She stood next to the sports giants of Under Armour and even been featured for the Muhammad Ali collection.
I have the prettiest footwork, the prettiest face.
A one-time model, Michaela doesn't mind the bright lights, but she says female fighters shouldn't have to show skin to get paid.
How you fight in the ring, your performance, your skill, that's all that should matter. Mm-hmm. But companies, they want to put a pretty face behind their product, and it's sad but true, and that's like the harsh realities of the world.
And another harsh reality, it's the men. Mayweather and Pacquiao ring a bell, who pack away the big purses and the pros, too. The top-ranking amateur female fighters make less than minimum wage from USA Boxing.
A typical championship fight for a woman professional, she'd make about $5,000 still, but a man professional for a championship fight, he's going to make hundreds of thousands and potentially millions of dollars.
Something that these heavy hitters are hoping they can knock out together.
I do believe I'm going to get a chance to headline in Vegas. You got to be, a woman that everybody wants to see fighting.
But this year, they have their sights not set on green, but on gold.
USA!
Just last month, we caught up with Michaela at the U.S. Olympic Training Center in Colorado Springs, where she and the other Olympic hopefuls from Team USA were living and training.
You're surrounded by athletes with the same common goal. So really, every direction you turn is an Olympic focus. It's almost like you're back in college a little bit, because it's kind of dorm style living and everyone eats in the same cafeteria. But, it's fun.
Wait, so I got you something.
Oh, yeah.
In the lead up to the Olympics, the fighters have become a family.
Okay.
Okay.
Close your eyes.
Okay.
And then put your hand out.
How cute is that?
Thank you so much, leverage in a case.
It's a sword! Oh, my gosh, I love it.
Isn't that so cute?
You better like it.
Oh, good job, Michaela. That is cute.
Supporting Michaela every step of the way to Rio, Jenny Fuchs, her main sparring partner and travel buddy for years.
Jenny, is obviously one of my best friends, and she's not competing in Rio, but she's going to be there with me, and, I'm super happy about that.
And, of course, Clarissa Shields, who is defending her own gold medal.
Clarissa is 5 years younger than me, but she's already an Olympic gold medalist. She's been here, she's done this. And so I look at her as inspiration, and she's gonna help me mentally when I'm there, knowing that I have her by my side.
Now you gotta shoot that cannon. Double the cannon up, okay?
Mixing a little fun with their fighting, the women even came up with code names for their punches.
Draw your sword, that's your jab. Fire the cannon. And then walk the plank and just walking them back towards the rope.
It's a lot of work, so we gotta find spots to kind of make ourselves laugh and have a good time.
And now, after years of hard work, dedication, and single-minded focus, Michaela's made it to Rio, and she says she's ready for the biggest fight of her life.
It was really a brutal path to get here, and the chances of actually making it were very slim, but to have such a dream, you have to really believe in yourself. You have to believe you're the best before you're the best.
For Nightline, I'm Rachel Smith in Atlanta.